Welcome students. So we will continue the topic, that is the molecular basis of inheritance. The topic, it carry the weightage according to the Markov scheme of the HSC board examination is 4 to 6 marks. That means compulsory for 4 marks, and with option the weightage carry for 4 to 6 marks. So under the molecular basis of inheritance, so last time we started about the 4.2 unit, that is the genetic material as a DNA, and under which we will completed the different evidences or the different cytologies which prove by performing their experiment which one is the genetic material, under which the first experiment we will study, that is about the Griffith experiment. And the Griffith carried the experiment by using the mice, and the mice which get infected by using the 2 different strains of the Streptococcus pneumoniae bacteria as R strain and S strain, which are respectively the pathogenic and the non-pathogenic, respectively the pathogenic R strain bacteria which are the non-pathogenic, and S strain bacteria which are the pathogenic bacteria. And finally the Griffith concluded that the some material which is the transforming principle and which cannot label it as the DNA. So again, to prove which one is the transforming principle, Avery, McCarty and McLeod's experiment, which carry the experiment to prove the DNA is the genetic material. The Avery experiment, which collect the blood sample from the 4th step of the Griffith experiment from the mice, and through the blood sample the different components like the DNA, carbohydrates, proteins get isolated, and then each component which allow in the medium in which the R strain bacteria which are grown. And then the Avery concluded that DNA is only the genetic material due to which the live R strain bacteria get converted into the live S strain bacteria. And again, for the confirmation, the Avery used the lysing enzymes like DNAs in the DNA medium, the medium containing DNA, added DNAs, and due to which the lysis of the DNA get achieved. That means the DNA get broken down, and at that time the transformation of the R strain bacteria into the S strain bacteria which was not get observed. And so finally the Avery concluded that the DNA must be the genetic material. Again, the third evidence to explain the genetic material as a DNA, that is the Hershey and Chase performed the experiment termed as the Hershey and Chase experiment. The Hershey and Chase performed his experiment which worked by using the bacteriophages, that means the bacteriophage virus. The bacteriophage virus, that means the viruses which infect only the bacteria called as the bacteriophage virus. And the bacteriophages, that means the bacteriophage virus, There are two main components as DNA and the proteins. So in the last lecture, I will introduce about the structure of the bacteriophage virus. The bacteriophage virus shows the proteinous coat called as the capsid. So the whole one, which one is the proteinous coat? Here the head, tail, tail fibers, etc. So the protein is one of the main component, and inside it the another material, the genetic material is present, or the material is present, that is the DNA. So the DNA, only the DNA, and here in the coat the proteins, that is the proteinous coat. So the DNA and proteins, which are the two main components of the bacteriophage virus. So the Hershey and Chase, by using the bacteriophages which perform their experiment, and the bacteriophages which allowed to grow in the medium containing the phosphorus and sulfur, but which are the isotopes or the radioactive phosphorus and sulfur. So here the Hershey and Chase, which use the isotopes of the phosphorus and the sulfur, the alternative term, that is the radioactive phosphorus and the sulfur. So under the first step in the Hershey and Chase experiment, the viruses which allowed to grow in the medium containing the isotopes of the phosphorus and the sulfur as separately. That means the medium containing the isotope of phosphorus in one test tube or in one culture medium, and in another culture medium the viruses which are allowed to grow in the medium containing the radioactive sulfur. So here the first step, here I will draw in short as the test tube containing here the medium, and the medium with the radioactive sulfur. So the medium containing the radioactive sulfur, that means S35, the radioactive sulfur in the medium in which the bacteriophages which allowed to grow. And the another step, that is the in the medium there is a radioactive phosphorus, that means P32. So the Hershey and Chase experiment performed the experiment by using the isotopes of the phosphorus and sulfur, and separately the isotopes which are present in the separate culture medium, and in the separate culture medium the bacteriophages which are allowed to grow. The medium in which there is a radioactive sulfur, in which the viruses shows the radioactive capsid. The radioactive capsid, then question arises, we will study it in 11th standard, but I will repeat it again, the term capsid. Capsid, that means the coat, the outermost covering, the coat of the virus called as the capsid. So here the coat, and the coat is completely the proteinase coat. That means it composed by the proteins only. And so here the radioactive sulfur which enters in the radioactive capsid, that means in the proteinase coat. Then again question arises, the proteinase coat, in the proteinase coat the radioactive sulfur enters because again the sulfur is the main component of the protein and protein is the main component of the capsid. So the proteinase coat in which the main component is the sulfur, here the radioactive sulfur get used, and so the proteinase coat, that means the viruses, their proteinase coat, it shows the presence of the isotope of the sulfur, that is the capsid or the proteinase coat in which the radioactive sulfur enters. Then in the another culture medium where the isotope of the phosphorus get used and in which the viruses which are grown, which shows the radioactive phosphorus. So the viruses in which the radioactive phosphorus enters, and the radioactive phosphorus again particularly in the DNA, radioactive DNA. So here the DNA is present and the DNA, it becomes radioactive because again the phosphorus is the main component of the DNA. So here the DNA in which the phosphorus is the main component, while the protein in which sulfur is the main component, the Hersey and Chase separately in two separate culture medium use the isotope of the phosphorus and isotope of the sulfur, and in separate culture medium the viruses which grow allowed to grow, and then observed that the medium in which isotope of sulfur present, in which the radioactive sulfur enters in the proteinase coat, that means in the capsid, while the viruses which grown in the isotope of phosphorus, in which the radioactive phosphorus enters in the radioactive DNA, because which one is the component of the DNA. So the first step you can understand here about, we get understood about the first step, that is by using the isotopes, the in separate culture medium the viruses which again becomes the radioactive, but in the first step the viruses, the proteinase coat become radioactive, and here in second step or another medium the viruses, you know, in which only the DNA becomes the radioactive. Then the next step, major step, so suppose this one is the A step, this one is the B step for our understanding only. So here the radioactive phases, so in both culture medium the bacteriophages becomes radioactive. Here only the bacteriophage become radioactive in by the proteinase coat, and here the DNA becomes radioactive. So all the radioactive phages allowed to infect. We will study the property or the typical feature of the bacteriophage which only infect the bacteria, and particularly the E. coli bacteria, Escherichia coli bacteria. And so such a radioactive phages, the radioactive viruses which allow to infect the E. coli bacteria, but the E. coli bacterium which grown in the culture, the medium which shows the presence of the normal phosphorus and sulfur, that means there is no necessity, or the Hersey and Chase not use the isotope, at the time of the growing the E. coli bacterium, and then such mediums which in which the viruses enter the radioactive phases which allow to infect the E. coli bacteria. I will again repeat this stage. Again, there are similarly the two separate culture medium. In two separate culture medium, the bacteria, particularly the E. coli bacteria, which get allowed to infect by the virus, which allowed to infect the virus, which are radioactive, and the radioactive with the radioactive sulfur. That means here the under the A step, the first one, here the radioactive sulfur get enters in the bacteriophage virus, and such a radioactive virus is allowed to infect the bacterium in the medium, but the medium which contains the normal sulfur. There is no any isotope. The normal culture medium get used here, and then the Hershey and Chase observed that which allowed to culture, which allowed to grow at that time the virus infect the bacteria, and then the Hershey and Chase observed that the bacteria, the E. coli bacteria, remains normal. Normal, that means not any radioactive component, that means not any radioactive sulfur or the radioactive phosphorus enters in the bacterium. I will again later on explain it with help of the diagram. And the another medium in which the normal medium containing the E. coli bacteria, which allowed to infect with the help of the viruses which are the radioactive, and the radioactive phosphorus is present here in the virus. And then the Hershey and Chase observed that the infected bacterium which becomes radioactive. So I will again explain the step, second step, with the help of the diagrams. So the second step, that is the radioactive phases. So here both phases are the radioactive phases. But here the radioactive phases, phases means bacteriophage virus. Here the radioactive phases which shows the presence of sulfur labeled capsule. Again, there is an alternative term for the radioactive sulfur. It also denoted as the sulfur labeled capsule, which indicates that the sulfur labeled capsule, that means it contains the radioactive sulfur. It termed as also the sulfur labeled capsule. Okay, we can understand. Always the alternative terms again, which are important one in the multiple choice question. Again, such a type of question may be asked by using the alternative terms. And so here the radioactive virus, bacteriophage virus, shows the radioactive sulfur, that means sulfur labeled capsule. Capsule, that means their proteinous coat. The another radioactive virus, that is the bacteriophage virus, which shows presence of phosphorus, that is the labeled DNA. The phosphorus labeled DNA, that means it indicates that here the radioactive phosphorus present in the DNA. So somewhat by using the colored chalk, by our understanding here the red colored chalk shows here the capsid, which one is the radioactive due to the radioactive sulfur, while here the DNA is the radioactive due to the radioactive phosphorus. So both types of radioactive viruses here in the first step of the Hershey and Chase the radioactive viruses which are grown by using such a type of mediums. Then later on, such radioactive viruses which allow to infect the E. coli bacterium, which allow to infect E. coli bacterium, Escherichia coli bacterium. We studied the typical characteristic, that is the viruses which only infect the bacteria, and the particular type of bacterium, that is the E. coli bacterium. Always you know the specific typical characteristic feature of the virus. The viruses which are very specific, which are the disease causing entities, and some viruses only cause the disease only to the plant, called as the plant viruses. Some virus which only cause the disease, called as the animal viruses. And some virus which only cause the disease, that means only infect the bacteria, called as the bacteriophage virus, bacteriophages. So here the E. coli bacterium which get allowed to infect by using the radioactive bacteriophages. So here the radioactive bacteriophages added in the medium, suppose the E. coli bacterium, which allow to grow in the medium, and always the medium which containing contains normal phosphorus and the sulfur separately. Here the bacteriophage shows the sulfur labeled capsule, and here the bacteriophage which shows the labeled DNA, that means the radioactive phosphorus in the DNA. So the E. coli bacterium which allow to infect by the radioactive viruses in the medium, the medium contains the normal phosphorus and the sulfur. So you can understand about this. Here the medium contains the normal phosphorus and sulfur, while in the first step of the Hersey and Chase, the medium get used here only the culture in which the bacteriophage viruses allowed to multiply, and at that time in the medium, here in both separate medium, the isotope of the phosphorus, sorry, here sulfur and the phosphorus, which get added separately. So the isotopes get used in the first step to allow to only the grow, to only the multiply the bacteriophages, while here in second step, the E. coli bacterium which allow to multiply, as well as at the same time the viruses also get added, and which infect the E. coli bacterium, the viruses which are the radioactive viruses, radioactive bacteriophages. Then later on, as if it allowed to grow, allowed to culture, allowed to multiply in the culture, at that time the viruses which initially with the help of their tail fibers which fix the capsule of the E. coli bacterium, penetrates their tail fibers in the capsule, and the tail, somewhat the tail which functioning as a spring like structure. So here the virus, very spontaneous and the fast process, the virus, they are particularly here the tail, this one, the tail which very forcefully get compressed, and immediately again it becomes in their normal position. So due to the head of the virus, bacteriophage, very fastly and spontaneous process due to the compression of the tail, forcefully which comes near to the capsule and immediately forcefully again in their original position, and at that time the material which one is present inside the bacteriophage virus forcefully which enters in the E. coli bacterium. So here we can clearly observe that suppose here the bacteriophage virus, first the process of the penetration, and later on in the next step here the material which is present inside the proteinous coat, that is the DNA, which get enter in the E. coli bacterium. Here also we can observe that the genetic material, that means the DNA, get enters in the E. coli bacterium, and later on after that here the capsid, the proteinous coat, the proteinous coat, it becomes separate like this. Only the material which present inside the capsid which get enters in the E. coli bacterium, and ultimately suppose in this step, in this culture medium, the E. coli bacterium with the help of the centrifugation by isolating the different components, the Hershey and Chase observed that there is no sulfur, actually here the sulfur, that means the isotope of the sulfur, which not detected in the bacterium, that means the bacterium which are non radioactive bacterium. So the 1 minute, here the there is no radioactive sulfur, that means suppose the 35 so the S35, that means the isotope of the sulfur not detected in the bacterium, and that means we can say as here the bacterium is non radioactive bacterium. So the bacterium is non-radioactive bacterium because the sulfur labeled capsule which remains outside the E. coli bacterium, and so which one is the non-radioactive. While in this culture medium the E. coli bacterium get allowed to multiply by using the bacteriophage containing the labeled DNA, the labeled DNA enters in the E. coli bacterium, and due to which again by the centrifugation and isolating the different components, the Hershey and Chase observed that the phosphorus, again here the phosphorus, that means the isotope of the phosphorus, that means the radioactive phosphorus, radioactive phosphorus detected in this bacterium. Here the radioactive phosphorus detected in the bacterium, here there is no any radioactive substance, that means maybe the sulfur or phosphorus, because the capsid remains outside. That means in this step here we can observe that the bacterium which becomes here the radioactive, so the bacterium becomes radioactive bacterium. And so from this experiment Hershey and Chase concluded that the substance there is somewhat the confusing or the somewhat the puzzling, which one is actually the genetic material, the protein or DNA? There are only two components. And so here the Hersant says, use the bacteriophages for their experiment to prove which one is the genetic material, because only two components present, and protein is not the genetic material, or protein not enters in the E. coli bacterium, only the DNA get enters in the E. coli bacterium. And by using the radioactive isotopes, the Hersant says concluded that DNA must be the genetic material. And so which one is again the third experiment or the very important evidence to explain the genetic material as a DNA? That is completely about the Hersey and the Says experiment. The question may be asked on the Hersey and Says experiment, maybe for 3 or 5 marks, explain the Hersey and Says experiment in detail for 5 marks, or maybe sometimes very rarely the only the diagram which explains about the Hersey and Says experiment, the diagram also given in your textbook, 12th standard textbook also the diagram given. And so in this way here the unit 4.2 completed, that is the genetic material as a DNA. So up till now the question not asked as a long answer question totally about the explain the all experiments, not at all. The question may be asked separately, maybe only on the Griffith experiment, maybe only on the Avery experiment or the Hersey and Says experiment. So on this unit there are number of multiple choice questions may be get asked, in which experiment the isotope get used. So the Hersey and Says experiment, in which the isotopes of the phosphorus and sulfur get used, the isotopes of the which chemical component get used, that is the phosphorus and the sulfur, what is the transforming principle, the question may be asked, answer in one sentence also. The Avery experiment uses the lysing agents or the lysing enzymes like DNAs, proteases. So only here the Avery uses such enzymes which lyse the DNA or the proteins or the RNAs to lyse the RNA. So which one is again the important about the Avery experiment? One minute.